Hi guys, today's question is, how do you develop an insane work ethic and discipline? Stay tuned. Okay, so today's question is from Justin. How do you develop an insane work ethic and discipline? So the number one thing I'll say about this is, why do you want to develop an insane work ethic and discipline? Because as I've talked about in other videos, I do not naturally have a strong work ethic. I can be incredibly lazy. What I do is I get obsessed with projects with work that I love. When you become obsessed with something, when it becomes something that you can't keep yourself away from, then you don't have to worry about work ethic or discipline. You can't pull yourself away from that. So how do you actually find things that are going to obsess you in that way? Two basic ideas. So the first thing is, find work that you love the doing more than the result. Number two is, pick projects that are potential game changers. One of the reasons that I love writing books and always considered books a greater passion of mine than something like writing an op-ed is because a book is a potential game changer. It can change the debate and it can change my life. And so that becomes huge motivation. So I love the writing. I love the actual experience of writing. And when I know that I'm working on something that is a potential game changer, now I have all the ingredients of the kind of obsession that's going to carry me forward. Now, okay, you've got a career you're passionate about, you love the doing, you've got a project that you're obsessed about, but you still need to push yourself a little harder, you need to bring your game up a little bit more. Here's a couple tools on how to do that. First, out of all the productivity books, podcasts, lectures that I've heard, only one tactical piece of advice has really stayed with me and changed my life, and that is a book by Brian Tracy called Eat That Frog. Now, you don't have to read the book because I'm going to give you the one key insight, and it's very simple. You start out every day before you do anything else working on the hardest, scariest, most high-value project or task that's on your plate. This does a couple of things. First of all, it actually moves the project forward in a meaningful way, and I found that I was making 10 times more progress just from the sheer fact of every day advancing the highest leverage thing I could be advancing. Number two, it creates momentum. So everything else in the day feels like you're playing with house money and it feels far easier than that first project. And so you can really magnify your productivity just by eating that frog, doing that hardest thing first. Next, feedback and accountability. This is something that's a lot easier for writers than maybe some other spheres, but as a writer, I have to send my work to an editor. And I know that they're going to be looking for mistakes, they're going to be looking for problems, and so A, I have that deadline to send it to them, and B, I know that I need to be as good as possible because they are going to find flaws into it, and I don't want them to find flaws. If I do, I don't want it to mean I have to throw out everything and start again. So I'm going to work a little bit harder, a little bit better, and the added bonus, really the major bonus is, if they're good, that feedback is going to accelerate my learning and achievement even more. Finally, if you want to increase your day-to-day motivation, I talked about this in my Be Like Mike video a few weeks back, you can use motivational tools. These are not the kinds of things that are going to give you enduring motivation over a year or 2 years or 3 years, and nor should they, but they can really help you in the moments when you need to rise to the occasion. And those are what I've talked about as looking for inspiration and looking for competition. So inspiration can just be watching that Steve Jobs speech, looking around at the people around you who you think are really playing the game right, and that can cause you and encourage you to rise to the occasion. The second is competition. Who are the people that you want to outdo? You want to pit your best against their best. And again, that's not the kind of thing that should drive you and help you choose your goals, but in the moment, it can help you do even better. All right, thanks guys. Like this video, subscribe to the YouTube channel, and if you want more of this content, the best way is to go to donswriting.com and sign up for the newsletter. Talk to you soon.